It's Coach Ryan with Wolfman. Welcome to the Sling-Shot shooting system. The Sling-Shot is going to have you scoring goals like Austin Matthews and Wolfman's favorite, Leon Draisaitl.
It's a seven-step learning process.
So I'm going to show you step one. You're going to practice. Then we're going to add step two, step three, step four, and so on. It's very important. We're not worried about the result of the puck at the start. It's more about getting the form down throughout the body. What you're going to need is a pair of hockey gloves, a stick. You can use your game stick, but preferably don't. Let's get some running shoes on, not flip-flops. And I want you to get a bunch of pucks. Mom, Dad, 25 pucks is not going to do it. You need at least 100 to get the repetitions down. All right, so you got all your gear. Let's get a good warm-up in first. Let's go.
First, focus on fueling. Fueling is the first principle and focus on the fueling. This way, you can improve the mechanics of the stroke too. If you had a bad habit, bad mechanics of the stroke, you should correct it now. So please remember, fueling is the most important, and when you master the fueling, now you can try to hit hard and harder by focusing on the fueling.
For the warm-up, we're going to get a bunch of pucks, let's say 25, and we're simply going to get puck touches. Don't worry about form, just puck touches to the net. Go! What Wolf is focusing on here is feeling the puck through the blade, through the shaft, in through his hands, throughout the rest of his body, nose to toes. We're connecting the puck to the body.
Here is the trick to shooting, okay? The slingshot shooting way, and the way to get the most leverage from your shot. And once you see this, you can unsee it. And it's so simple. Here is the simple component of it. The puck is like physically behind your hands. That's here. It. If the puck is here, get it behind your hands, then shoot. And so we'll watch what Matthews does here like this. Or puck behind his hands, and then shoot. That simple.
Step one is lead with the hands. So we're gonna have a toes to the net stance and simply just lead with the hands, Wolf. Show us what that looks like. Hands are leading to the net. Good. Now let's load a puck up. You wanna have the puck
behind your hands.
The butt. And now simply lead with the hands. Great. Grab the puck, lead with the hands. We're not focused on the result. We're focused on the feeling. Awesome. Fantastic. Good job.
So here. And so you almost need to just think of having your hands in this shooting position here on where the puck is there. And then they just end over here. So, and then you connect it. And so you can test this out.
Step two, hands in the back pocket. So Wolf puts his stick down. We lead with the hands and end up in the back pocket. Keep going, Wolf. Yep. Hands, back pocket. Knob hand, back pocket. Blade hand, back pocket. Great. Okay, so now we're going to load up some pucks and we're going to lead with the hands and then end up with the hands in the back pocket. Great. Wonderful. Let's not worry about the result. Even though the result might be awesome, that's not what we're focused on. Are the toes facing the net? Are we leading with the hands? And are the hands coming all the way into the back pocket, creating that
elastic slingshot stretched throughout the back.
So this is really cool. If you get your weight to the heel, it allows you to carry less tension in the leg. And if you have less tension in the leg, your hips can rotate more freely. It's magic. Some might call it a magic mechanic. Everyone watching? Watch, watch, watch. Oh, what do you see right there? Look at that. Is on these shots, you see the weight transfer to the heel a lot. When doing the slingshot, having your weight to your heels allows you to rotate a lot better.
Step three, heel pressure. So we have a nice wide stance, and just show us what heel pressure looks like, Wolf. That's it. So we're just rocking back. So we take the weight off the toes. So we have about 80% of the weight into the heels. Just rock a little bit, Wolf. That's it. So show us a loaded toe. Show us a loaded heel. That's what we want to do. So step one is going to be a heel pressure. Step two, lead with the hands. And step three, back pocket. Show us what it looks like. Good. So here we're focusing on heel pressure. As soon as that puck is on the blade, load the heels and then follow with the hands right into the back pocket. Mom, Dad, we're not worried about the results. Again, even if the result is awesome, that's a bonus. We're focusing on form of the body. Good. Awesome. How's that feeling?
Good.
Nice. Forward shin angle. So Wolf, show us our base stance, toes to the net. Awesome. We have heel pressure, and now we're gonna go forward shin angle. So pushing the knees, or let's think about, not the knees, but think about the ankles or the shins, pushing them forward. Good. Now we lead with the hands, back pocket. Good. Do a few more repetitions of that, Wolf. Good. And I want you to get the feeling of this. This is like our shadow skating. This is our shadow shooting. And again, parents, film this. And then let your player see, are they really pushing their shin angle to as much as their full capability? Let's not micromanage during the practice session. Trust the process. If everyone is not perfect, that's okay.
When you're shooting, you might be like, pay attention to the muscles in your face. And then you're like, oh, wow, I can just relax them while I shoot. And then that's kind of cool. And other times you might say like, pay attention to your breathing while you shoot. And you realize like, oh my God, I'm just holding my breath. Like I'm not breathing. So any of those like awareness cues kind of taps into that ability to just literally be aware and then relax, right?
Wolf, show me what blow out the birthday candle looks like. Good. Blow out a birthday candle. So instead of hearing a tension, we want to release the tension. Go. Great. Whoa, that sounded good. Once they can self-monitor themselves, the progress will happen so much faster. Really feel good about these. Whoa. Coach felt good about that one. Okay, beautiful. Let's end it there. So that's a high note. Okay, good. Awesome.
Second, hit by the legs. Hit by the legs. Most veteran players are taught to hit with the arm, The Chinese say hit by the legs. By hitting with the legs, the whole body will also be used in the stroke. This way, the stroke is stronger and much more consistent.
But watch Federer here. Watch how the weight is actually at his heels, right? And then he rotates with the weight on his heel on this left foot here. The weight is actually through his heel there, which was really surprising to me. Even here, for example, notice weight actually on the heel.
We've got forward shin angle. We've got lead with the hands into the back pocket. Blow out the birthday candle. Good. Now, hold that, Wolf. Show me tennis feet. Yeah. So we're rotating to that outside edge. Really lift up that ankle bone. Get to that outside edge. And we're rotating this foot. So give me four of those just with shadow shooting. Good. Nice. And you can see that rotation to the outside edge foot and put everything together. Good. Good. So the player is obviously going to be thinking about all the steps, which is why we're practicing. So we're going through that checklist, and eventually we get into that stage in a game playing situation where it just happens and it looks effortless. You want to have that tennis player bounce. So when you're loading up the puck, bounce like a tennis player waiting for a serve. Obviously not hopping, but active feet, heel pressure, forward shin angle. Exhale, hands into the back pocket. Yeah.
Now, you might be wondering what you're looking at. This is an eye tracking exercise designed to improve your aim and focus in Fortnite. You see, what most people don't realize is that the majority of your aiming is done with your eyes. Your muscle memory is usually pretty consistent and better than you think, meaning your fingers and your hands are usually doing their job very well. But where huge leaps in aim improvement can be made is with focus, particularly visual tracking of an enemy or quick target acquisition with your eyes. We all can get easily distracted or lose focus during combat with all the excessive particle effects and intense action going on. So there's gotta be a way to improve this skill. Enter eye training.
Okay, now we're gonna have some fun. We're gonna work on vision with the slingshot shooting system. So we have our targets. We've got our water bottle poppers up there. You're gonna take your eyes and you're gonna lock on your target. Cool? Okay, let's see what you got here. Water bottle poppers. Nice. Woo-hoo-hoo! And there you go, Mom and Dad. Wolf, let's turn around here, bud. There you go. Step by step, learn the mechanics, and then score more goals. It's as easy as that. Fantastic.
I highly recommend learning the feeling of the slingshot in shoes. You can practice in shoes as much as you want. The best carryover onto the ice is if you wear your Marblades. Because your feet are now balancing on a blade, the nervous system has to relearn the seven steps of the slingshot. So expect a natural regression. Stay patient, stay positive. Remember the 7-step checklist. Keep covering that every shot. And the more you practice off ice on your Mars Blades, the more dynamic and effortless you're going to be on the ice. Hi, it's Coach Ryan. Hockey parents, if you ever want a hockey talk, send me a text.